Homecoming is a big deal.
Homecoming is like a stress reliever. It's like that opportunity that you have to be able to like take a break from the real world or the stresses of school if you're still in school and be able to just have a good time and just remember why you chose Hampton and why you chose an HBCU.
It's always the people and then, you know, small changes on campus that make a big difference. People want to see that in person. So things like Legacy Park, you know, a lot of alum come back and they're like, what is this thing? It wasn't here when I was here.
Well, I just think as we get older, you start to think about, you know, what's important to you and the foundation you built back in the day. And it's just nothing like it when you can come back and just see people that you've grown with over the course of 20, 30, 40 years.
It's another world and it's a different world and it's something that you just really, really can't explain.
I really kind of feel bad for those who didn't attend HBCU because we have a sense of family.
I think it's more of an escape, you know, from life's, you know, running around with kids and job and everything that we have to do.
But it's nothing like Hampton University. And this is the reason why I come back. I come back to see some folks. I met a class kind of people down here. I always say it. And I like to see them when I come back.
Hampton's Mecca for me.
Homecoming feeds my soul. And what I mean by that is the people, my friends, the relationships, Ebony Fire, Delta Sigma Theta, the band, every organization that I was a part of at Hampton brings me back.
Homecoming is everything. I really look forward to coming, seeing my family, my friends, and getting a fill-up of love, a fill-up of hugs, a fill-up of friendship and community.
Hampton is an annual thing that we have to plan for. Everyone in the house knows. When it's time for homecoming, get ready.
It's a big freaking deal.
Literally, when you walk in a hotel that's just filled with Hamptonians, your heart's just full because that's your family.
Cool. So we talked about homecoming. We here shooting a movie, man. That's one thing I never thought I'd be doing either, man. But when you in tune with what's going on, you just want to find ways to put out some creativity, in some cases on the entrepreneurship. And we started exploring our love for Hampton. I've been out of school 30 years. I only missed homecoming twice. And what I realize is I'm not the only one like that, right? I'm not the only one like that. It's a bunch of folks just like me. So we started thinking about it and we're saying, well, you know, what is it about this love for Hampton? Why do we have to come back? Like, why are we upset when we can't make homecoming? Why do we feel withdrawal on Monday morning after homecoming, you know?
You know, being here this long, I can genuinely say I've come across folks who love this place.
From the standpoint of homecoming, you know, this film is really about how the football team, so now we both play football, so you know what it's like, how you get ready for the big game, right? It's technical preparation, it's X's and O's, it's practice, it's getting in shape, it's all that kind of stuff. But the larger story is how alumni, students, and staff get ready for homecoming because it's just as involved.
All right, so how we get ready for homecoming, it really starts almost a year in advance. It starts with recruiting and show planning. Right around January timeframe, we start to throw out ideas, we start to get song ideas, show design ideas, and at the same time we're also recruiting. So we're looking at the type of student that we want to bring into the band. We do offer scholarships, and one of the reasons is because just like a football player would train in the weight room, they put in the work when they could be doing something else. So now they are more valued as an asset to that team. In order to put a good show on the field, we can't teach somebody from scratch. We have to have high quality musicians that are able to hop right in and know what they need to do in order to succeed on the field. And by the time August rolls around, all the band is coming here for band camp about a month before classes start. So we have to get them prepared on the fundamentals, not just playing and marching, but we also have to get them acclimated to the heat so that, when homecoming does roll around, even though it might be cooler that day, they have the hot uniforms on and they're exerting themselves. So you talk about a high energy performance. We have to be in shape. As we put the show together, we start to look at what works, what doesn't work, what is gonna be the most engaging to the audience, what's gonna have them feel what we are playing and leave them with something, some memory that they can take back with.
Well, for us, it's pretty much ready or not, here they come. We are planning from the start of the actual calendar year, beginning in January, looking at unique ways and ideas and ways to engage alumni. We are hoping to be able to have our list of activities and events ready to launch by the end of the summer, so that when we are all turning over into the new academic year, we're all set and ready to go.
We are really excited about the activities. A major event is our homecoming concert, yes, which now is host on Thursdays. And so we try to bring in the latest, greatest artists specifically for our students. And we have Lil Baby, not little, but Lil Baby.
Da Baby, D.A. Baby. Yeah, there's a few babies, but we gonna get them all.
The baby, he just came out with a new album. This is a big part of his promotion too. So if I was to talk to him, I would ask him about the album and what's next for him, and even what's his message to the college kids.
Okay, we're gonna make a special hashtag so we can check if everybody's posting, because at this point we really want everybody to be posting everything.
I've been a part of the homecoming committee since I was a sophomore. I started off as an intern, and then last year I did the 12 to 2 committee. So this year being a co-director is like really exciting, but it's also a little stressful. I'm not gonna lie, it's really stressful. My dad went here, my stepmom went here, my sister went here. So I feel like homecoming, like they always have talked about homecoming, always talked about coming to homecoming. Like, oh, you going to homecoming? Yeah, I'm coming to homecoming. Like, it's just always something that they're talking about. So for it to be so important in my family, I feel like that makes me excited for it also.
My name is Vince Rose, and I'm a junior psychology major, Naval Science Leadership minor from Yorktown, Virginia. And I prepare for homecoming by being responsible, not overindulging, and staying hydrated.
All right, my name is Julius Ogunde. I'm a first year kinesiology major coming from Montgomery County, Maryland. And how I get ready for homecoming, you gotta get bibbed up first, you know what I'm saying? Then you gotta get your freshest line of outfits ready. And most important thing, gotta make sure you smell good, because you're gonna be in close quarters with a lot of females. Hampton University got the finest females on the planet, no cap.
Good afternoon, my name is Caitlin Chower. I'm a junior psychology pre-med major from Connecticut. And how I get ready for homecoming is I stay ready. Always come prepared, getting ready for the concert, all the festivities going on, the food trucks, everything.
My name is Max Brown. I'm from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. I'm a 5-year MBA major, and how I get ready for homecoming, let's see, you know, you gotta get the fresh cut.
I've been here for about 2 years. It's exciting, man. You see a lot of people, a lot of regulars, you know, new people. And new people is where it's at, new clientele.
This is my 4th year doing homecoming. I usually open up my schedule 2 more hours, so I stay about 7 or 8. And I got good clients. They usually bring me some food, gum, drinks, liquor. They got to get on my calendar. So I only go by appointments. If you want the time that you want, you want to get on there early, like 2 weeks. I get so busy that I can't go pee. I can't pee, I can't eat.
You can look at pictures and stuff like that, or, you know, just wait to see if your barber cut anybody. All day long, students are in and out, constantly. It never stops. It's a revolving door, like you see, it's open now.
Kyrie Parrish, marine biology and environmental science student from Maplewood, New Jersey. And how I get ready for homecoming? Well, over here, the sailing team will be traveling to the War Memorial Championship in Annapolis, Maryland over the weekend. So we have to make sure we take care of our books right now, our classes, our tests, and make sure we have fun right now, because when the weekend comes, it's time to win.
Hi, I'm Elizabeth Kuster. I am from Milan, Italy, and I'm a senior accounting major here at Hampton University. I will get ready for homecoming by practicing today and on Thursday, because this weekend we have the most important regatta of the season in Annapolis, the War Memorial.
My name is Mercedes Matlock from Frederick, Maryland. I'm a cellular molecular biology major with a nanoscience minor, and how I get ready for homecoming is hitting the books, practicing, and winning the regatta.
Luca Taglialegne from Venice, Italy, Business Administration major. I personally have never participated in homecoming, and the way I prepare for homecoming is by sailing and kicking butts.
Hi, my name is Alex Ambrosi. I am the coach of the sailing team Hampton University, and we are preparing homecoming, doing practice, coaching, fundraising, and be happy.
So what excites undergrad students about homecoming? I think it's the experience. It's like the opportunity to pop out. Like Hampton is known for popping out. So I feel like it's that part. And then it's also like the concert's really exciting, like finding out who the artist is, and then like seeing all the alumni that come that weekend, going to the tailgate, going to the bazaar. I think it's like so many components that make everybody excited about it. So popping out is basically just dressing up like really well, like wearing heels, like, you know, doing your face, getting your hair done. Like, it's just making sure you look good. That's basically what popping out is.
You gotta see what your boys is on. You gotta see what the moves are. You know, yeah. What's the plans? They got a whole like list of things for events for every day for homecoming week. So we stay up on that. You don't want to go to every party, but you decide, all right, this day I'm finna be on this move. This day I'm gonna be on this move.
Hey everyone, my name is Randy Longs. I'm from Atlanta, Georgia, and I'm a part of QT11, the hottest class under the sun. How do I get ready for homecoming? Making sure my hair is ready, eyelashes, makeup, everything has to be in line. Clothes, I have to get them ready. Ordering Fashion Nova, all online stores. Just making sure I'm ready to look as best as I can for Saturday game day.
So there is a process. Of course, there's hair and nails, always. Try to lose that 10 pounds. Doesn't always happen, and especially the older we get. So that's kind of what the prep is like. You know, what am I gonna wear? Even though I wear the same thing every year.
Extra backup clothes in case those clothes that you thought were on point end up being a dub. Hair products, because this humidity does not play with us.
How do I get ready for homecoming? I make sure that I have my days in at work so that I can make sure that I have the time off.
That is key.
Make sure that I get my plane tickets in advance so I'm not paying $500 for 2 dates. And then I make sure I know the right parties to attend, and that's it.
And how I get ready for homecoming is I call Jen because she knows the right parties to attend, and I just go online, buy my ticket, and make sure I'm in touch with her.
Back in the day, we would be, you know, shopping, trying to find, you know, the finest clothes, and had to come, and, you know, it didn't matter if your feet was going to hurt or whatever, right? Now, I would say, you know, it's a lot easier process, but it's definitely, it starts with, what am I going to wear?
Just have a good time. So you want to be your best. You want to look your best. You want to feel your best. So you have to even work on getting that extra sleep, because you know that you're not going to get sleep while you're here.
For, I guess, a girl is the outfit. How are you going to come back? What are you going to put on since the last time that they saw you last year? So that's like my first step. And then for me, my hair. I'm a natural curly girl, so I have to prepare for my hair. That's a big deal.
My name is Liam Mims. I'm from Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. My major is bio pre-med, and I got ready for homecoming by spending all last week getting my homework done, so this week I can get teed up.
Require multiple outfits. That's true. Thursday, I'm probably going to get back to like there's like a kickback that's happening, but I'm working a full day at work. Okay. So I'm going to get off from work and then go try to see everybody. Friday morning, we have the 40 under 40 brunch in the morning. So I'm emceeing the induction ceremony for that, for the tailgate and for the game. And then there's something else for later on that night. It seems like every year we extend this. Yeah. You know, it used to be just the undergrad that did the whole week, and now it's kind of, we've extended it.
Again, my love for Hampton also started with going to the games and seeing the band. And the one thing I knew was I was going to audition for Ebony Fire. So when I got to Hampton, I missed auditions, but that was the first thing I did in the spring of my freshman year. Made the team, I was excited, and I danced for the remainder of my time here. Now, I'm fortunate enough to serve as the longest running coach for the team. I've been coaching since 2005.
All that is good!
Takes work.
Takes work.
Takes work.
Takes work.
Takes hard work.
Takes hard work.
And everything else.
And everything else.
And everything.
Dawn Blayton, Hampton University, marketing major. Original members of Ebony Fire, 36 years. And also, I'm here because it's my 35th reunion for pledging Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated Gamma Theta. That's Federal Express.
My stepmom, Sean, she gets so excited for homecoming every year.
We are having our 36th reunion for Ebony Fire. And we are, for the first time, coming together with over 55 dancers. Participating in an opportunity to represent our legacy from 1983. Both Sean and I were original members of Ebony Fire.
So just like back then, we had to look right and be tight and be classy. And so months ago, we were running. As you can see, I'm an eater. And so the exercising and everything, and I'll be doing that until Saturday so that I can fit in my outfit. And we did that also back then in 1983. Ebony Fire, The Force, every part of that band has to be conditioned before you come out so that you can be ready and on point. It takes the same hard work and dedication that it did back then because we came together. I live in New York. I came to Baltimore to practice. We stayed there for 2 days straight and we practiced and I shot back home to go to work. It's the same hard work and dedication that we had then because you have to have a certain standard when you come out as Ebony Fire.
What's up, y'all? My name is Jacob Robinson. I'm a first-year, five-year MBA major, leadership studies minor from Atlanta, Georgia. And how do I get ready for homecoming? Well, of course, you already go ahead and get your classwork done before then and everything like that. But as far as during homecoming, you gotta make sure you're going to the parties on time and getting lit before, if you know what I mean. You gotta line up your Ubers, make sure they're straight, you know. The most important thing really is just to go ahead and enjoy the process. A lot of the events that are going on, you see people building their floats for the parade that are coming up, and it's really just having fun throughout the entire thing. So that's how I get ready.
I'm Victoria Joseph, a second year communicative sciences and disorders major from Compton, California, and I get ready for homecoming by decorating the float with the National Hampton Alumni Association because I'm not getting money for free.
Hampton has been able to increase the activities for students and alumni during homecoming, kind of split alumni affairs up with what the undergrads want to do and yet bring it all together. But there are just a lot more activities that students have the opportunity to experience.
We've been doing one of the longest running events here at Hampton University at the bowling alley, Spare Times.
And the bowling party is special just because you know your folks going to be there. So I believe the people that give it are in either in 89 and 90. Then you have people who have connected with them that are 91, 92, 93, and 94. Yeah. So that was a whole lot of classes, a whole lot of friends. So you know that if you come to homecoming, if people are here on Friday night, you know they're going to be at the bowling party. That's where you find your folks.
Because it's important here that we actually have something for the Hampton alumni to come back and celebrate one another. Because a common space creates common ground for common alignment, for us to have a great time.
Homecomings are amazing. It's a big family reunion. I didn't go to Hampton, but my sister went to Hampton and my grandfather. So I've been to the campus a lot before. And everywhere you go, the love is just, it's overflowing. It's a beautiful thing.
We have a family legacy with my husband being a class of 87.
I met my wife here. She's a class of 1988. I've been blessed enough that both of my daughters attend Hampton.
My oldest daughter is a graduate of Hampton University, class of 2012, and my youngest daughter just applying to Hampton. I'm a member of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, and I was Miss Hampton 1987-88. We do a lot of things as former Miss Hamptons to support the university, fundraising efforts. So we had a major anniversary, 150 years of Hampton University and Dr. Harvey's 40-year legacy.
In a single generation, Hampton has transformed from a small black college into a world-class research institution. And that transformation has come through the efforts of many people, but it has come through President Harvey's efforts in particular, and I want to commend him for his outstanding leadership as well as his great friendship to me.
Hampton is one of the jewels in the higher education enterprise in this entire country. And the fact is that this is my 41st homecoming. And there are so many memorable events. I don't know if I can single out one. It's just so great to be able to see so many alumni coming back, young alumni, old alumni, those that want to interact with Hampton being here at the prettiest campus in the entire world with all the great things that we got going on. It's just a wonderful, wonderful thing. So if you look at it, there isn't one thing that I can say that's so memorable other than the fact that it's Hampton University.
Yes, it's just different. And I have to tell you, they forecasted rain, but everybody knows that Dr. Harvey has a weather machine and he's ordering sun for tomorrow. So don't worry about it, we're gonna be fine.
I'm honored to be here this year for homecoming, especially because they asked me to be the Grand Marshal for the homecoming parade. And without reservation, I said, absolutely, I'll be there. I hope it doesn't rain on your parade.
Hey y'all, it's Bill Parrish, better known as F. William Samuel, class of 1989, Genesis 2. I'm here at Hampton Homecoming, y'all, and this is where it all started for me. James Hall, right here, back in 1985. Man, I remember like it was yesterday. The way I got to Hampton was high school day. I came to visit, and these folks know how to sell, and they know how to close. Because after I came down here and saw this beautiful campus, this nice weather, all these young ladies, all the classes they had to offer, I couldn't do anything else but say yes. And that's what I did on the spot, right then, high school day.
How much does it cost to go to Hampton Homecoming? It's becoming very expensive. And the biggest cost is the hotel.
So it's expensive. I mean, well, we're sitting here in the embassy and we know how costly that can be.
Just our hotel bill alone is about $1,000.
I fly from Chicago. This year I brought my kids. I'm embarrassed to say that our three plane tickets were $1,500. They expect to eat. I don't care about eating all weekend, but they do.
I would say maybe about $500 because I'm a smart shopper.
I do it big, Bill. My homecoming budget is about $2,000. I'm not playing around.
Right.
I'm gonna have a memorable time. I'm gonna have a good time.
I always throw like a little party in my suite, a little something I try to give back to the folks. I ask them for nothing, I just try to do something. I say $1,500.
Cost approximately for a homecoming would be well over $1,000.
It's probably at least $1,000, if not more.
If you're talking to a regular Hampton alum that just graduated, it's gonna be probably like $1,000, $1,200. Homecoming is expensive. It's something you need to save up for. It's something you need to take time off from work for.
Between donating to the school, between trying to donate to my class, that's probably a $1,500 venture for me.
And I mean, it's well worth it though, because I mean, it's some memories that every year it is just, it's great.
You have to think about your hair, your nails, your new outfits, your gas, your hotel, your food. But regardless of what all that costs, homecoming, it's priceless.